one thing that is not very clear to me is how features for inclusion, how to select features for inclusion in the RL model. With supervised learning, there are metrics like chi-squared, sequential features selection, etc. Are there clearer techniques for RL models? So I would like to say definitely yes. Like you have mentioned, chi-squared, sequential feature, there are hybrid models, embedded models as well. But if you look at trait data, right, when you are creating new features in your data set, be it some sort of difference time series, or be it any technical indicator, you are providing more information to the particular machine training, machine learning model, when the features are least correlated amongst themselves. They may be correlated with the return series, or they may be correlated with the price series. That's fine. But say, for instance, if you are using a moving average of 50 and a moving average of 100 as two features amongst other features which you're using for your ML model. Now, the information which a moving average 50 provides and a moving average 100 provides, that is not really added if you keep on adding different look-back periods for moving average. You need some sort of other information from the price data. Now, how to get this other information? This can be something as simple as volatility, or maybe average true range, or maybe some other indicator like parabolic SAR or ADX, or maybe the Hurst exponent values. So the underlying principle is to take least, or rather weakly correlated features, and then go ahead with your reinforcement learning model. Definitely, it's an iterative process, and you'll have to keep on trying different features. The word of caution here would be to not sort of overfit your parameters one particular asset on one or one particular time period of data, because if you try to keep your features or try to maximize your returns on a single asset in a particular data period, what you are essentially doing is that when you backtest it, it will perform really well. But if you deploy it in the live trading scenario, or maybe paper trading scenario, since you have overfit your model to run best on the data which you already know, that might give you a very bad return, or a very risky deployment for your algorithm. So overfitting should never be done. How to avoid this sort of overfitting? Now, maybe you can work with FX pairs, like FX pairs are usually mean reverting, right? So if you are implementing a mean reverting sort of strategy, and you have you can maybe trade up to 10 FX pairs, that's fine. But when you're backtesting, you should at least try to see if your strategy works on like 4 or 5 different FX pairs, just to eliminate the sense of bias that a particular asset was doing really well in that period of time. So that is why your strategy was doing well. And choosing different assets eliminates the possibility of any sort of bias. Maybe you can call it session bias, maybe you can call it regime bias. So that sort of bias can be removed.